Hey guys, welcome to another episode of California Ant Keeper. Today we're going to be doing an update on a few of my colonies. Let's start with my Liamepton occidentale colony. This colony has exploded. It's probably about four times as big as it was when my channel started a couple months ago. They have so much brood right now that it won't even fit in the Tar Heel ant's nucleus nest. And the queen is capable of laying over 65,000 eggs per year. All day in this section of the nest, I can sit here and just watch ants being born constantly. And I've taken this colony off of heat and I've reduced their protein so that way it'll control their population. Because there is so much brood, it won't even fit in the nest. In fact, they've actually made a mountain of brood in the trees in the outworld. I'm guessing that they've done this because this is the highest and warmest spot of the formicarium. And if you watched any of my old videos on my Liamepton colony, then you know the nucleus nest is not the only part of my Liamepton setup. I've connected two critter keepers via vinyl tubing to make this setup a lot larger and for a whole not a lot of money. But I'll probably have to add two more critter keepers very soon because this colony is growing out of control. They say that fire ants grow very fast, but this colony will definitely give fire ants a run for their money. This is the area where I do all the feeding, and every time I go in to refill one of those liquid feeders, at least 20 escape. And I've seen colonies of Liamepton in the wild, and the workers were much larger, so I know this colony has a long way to go to maturity. Right now, the workers are about three times the size of an Argentine ant, the common ants that invade our house in California. And this is the vinyl tubing I use to connect to the critter keepers. I estimate this colony to be about 25,000 workers right now. And my goal is to have the largest Liamepton occidentale colony in captivity. However, I do suggest that if you are new to ant keeping, that you stay far away from this species because they are very hard to contain. This whole dirt bin has been excavated and is completely hollow all the way through. And I've also seen them take brood inside there as well. Alright, enough of this colony. The next colony I wanted to update you guys on is my Camponotus curcicola. This colony has doubled since the first video on my channel. In my first video, I believe the queen only had 13 workers and she has about 33 now. I feed this colony about 20 fruit flies a day and some of the majors now are almost the size of the queen. This is my favorite type of Camponotus species because they are very large, they're shiny, and they're very active too. I have some Camponotus species like Vicinus that literally do nothing all day and those kind of species can get boring sometimes. But I do recommend this species if you are a beginner, but the growth rate will be very slow, so you'll just have to be a little patient. And if you decide to keep Camponotus in an acrylic nest like this one, I suggest you keep it dry for the most part. I used to fill up the humidity chamber daily, but I was noticing negative side effects. But this colony is booming now that I let it dry out, so I'm excited to see what's going to be in the future for this colony. The third colony I wanted to update you guys on today is my Novomesser Cockerelli. These girls have adapted to their new Pioneer XL nest very well, and they are growing rapidly. I estimate their workers to be about 800 at this time. They've excavated a lot of loose sand from this nest, and they've used it to bury their dead sisters. This Novomesser colony is eating about 600 fruit flies a day, and I noticed they don't go through that much sugar. It's been about a month since I changed that feeder. I like that it's always easy to spot the queen in this colony, because some colonies like my Liamepton occidentale, I never see the queen. One thing I've learned about Novomesser, that if you see their larva not eating like right there, then you can feed them more and they will grow even faster. This colony is very easy to take care of and they are very forgiving of beginner mistakes. However, I don't recommend this species to beginners because they grow so fast. This colony is not even a year old yet, and I have them in a giant nest. Most of the time when I read about somebody keeping this species of ant, they end up letting it go in the wild because they can't handle how fast the colony is growing. My goal with this colony is to have the largest Novomesser captive colony as well. And this is about the largest Novomesser colony I've seen. I've seen a couple that were about this size, but I haven't seen any that are larger. I'm kind of skeptical on how large these colonies can actually grow, because I've noticed their workers don't live as long as other species of ants. They always have a large pile of dead workers in their outworld, and I've seen this with many other ant keepers that keep Novomesser too. Right here, I put my finger up against the acrylic to give you guys a perspective of actually how large these ants are. I've always been fascinated with how different this species of ant really is compared to any other species in California. And at one point in time, this ant was actually classified as a phenogaster, but they ended up changing its name later on. I can't wait to attach the 20-gallon outworld I made for them. And wait, what's that worker doing right there? Looks like he has some nectar or something. Anyways, this colony is doing really good, and they are still my favorite colony. But the next colony we're going to talk about today is my Pogonomyrmex californicus. I was stung by one of these as a little kid, and I still remember how bad it hurt. It makes a bee sting feel like nothing. I always wondered why they included harvester ants in the Uncle Milton's farms for little kids back in the day, because these things hurt. I haven't been stung since, but this colony is doing very well since I showed them in my first video. They're probably about quadruple the size they were. This is just their outworld right now, but eventually it will be their tub and tube setup. That's all I have for today, guys. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and next video will be two more colonies I'll be adding to my collection. Thanks, guys. See you next time.